You're listening to or watching A Word from the Lord TV. My name is Pastor Michael Eaton, and I'm your host for today's program, as well as I serve as the senior pastor of the Bethlehem Baptist Church right here in the heart of Paul's Valley, Oklahoma. And I'm also co-founder of Word from the Lord, Inc., along with my lovely wife, Kimberly Eaton, who serves as the president of our organization. And we are so proud and elated that you have joined us today on the Now Television Network. And we are heard after Rodney Howard Brown, Kenneth Copeland, and Joyce Myers at 5:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time here in the United States. We're also heard on satellite television in 180 million households there in Europe, in London at 10:30, as well as in Africa, Logos, we're on at 10:30, and the Middle East at 10:30 in Israel. We're also heard on cable television here in America, and here are some stations that you can find us on. It is a 29 million households here on cable television here in the United States. And again, we're so glad that you've joined us today. We're going to talk about today, Black Love Must Matter Because of Christ, Colossians chapter 3, verses 14 through 17. And before we get into Word today, I want to make these resources available to you, which you can pick up at AWFTL with Dr. Michael and Kimberly Eaton.org. The first resource is Black Love Matters in the Bible, How to Apply God's Biblical Principles to Save Black Relationships and Families. That was my concern for writing this book, because 70% of our households don't have a man, a marriage, or a committed relationship in it. As a matter of fact, there is that red pill movement that is telling men that they shouldn't marry because they are fed up with the modern women who want the man that has 666. I told you on the show last week or the week before, that's in the Bible. It's the mark of the beast, 666. And these guys are beasting through our communities. They have six figures, six packs, and 6 feet. And they're running through the women in our community because the women in our community are running to them. And they don't have the character that is needed or the Black love that we're talking about in this book. So pick up this book. I'm challenging particularly young people to reconsider marriage, to reconsider love and family, because it can be the world's greatest blessing if done right, in Jesus' name. And before you, after you read this book, pick up our other resource, Sex and the Single Life, because God's going to have to work on you and get you ready for the kind of love that he wants. And you're going to have to learn how to live the single life God's way, understanding the will of God through the word of God. The book is Sex and the Single Life. Pick it up at AWFTL with Dr. Michael and Kimberly Eaton.org. Pick it up in Jesus' name. A Word from the Lord, Inc. also has a publishing house, and these are the authors in our house. And if you are looking to publish your work, and it is a Christian work, visit our website, AWFTL, with Dr. Michael and Kimberly Eaton.org, and we will see if we can partner together to tell your Christ stories. And these men have Christ stories. Reverend Chad Gray, I wrote a book, 40 from 40, 40 from 40 to 40. And it is a story about God's grace and mercy to the life of Chad Gray, who was sentenced 40 years in prison. But he's out today, and he's pastoring in Medea, Oklahoma. He's a senior pastor there, and God is using him in a great way. Charles Leslie is another great man of God who, on his Facebook page, you can go and he'll teach you these principles. Some things I've learned, but he's packaged these things and he wants to inspire the dreamers of the future. You can learn from his book some of the things that he's learned and get wisdom To live a better life. Cappuccino Adams, our latest author, is Life's Missing Link. If only I knew what I know now, life would be different. Most of us have that testimony. And these men, Cappuccino Sharing Wisdom, is just an awesome book, are trying to teach you so you won't have to experience the kind of life. And he's trying to show you what you're missing to help you to make the right choices for the future. So all of our authors are on Amazon.com. So visit their page there, Google their names, follow them on Facebook, in Jesus' name. The series today, once again, is Black Love Matters in the Bible. Black Love Matters in the Bible. I wrote a book, Black Lives Matters in the Bible. But in this book, I say in order for Black Lives to matter, Black Love must matter. We should be in an uproar. We should be going to Washington 100,000 strong and have all of our community leaders come up and espouse the value of love and family. This should be a movement. Hashtag Black Love Matters, in Jesus' name. I'm preaching this series so that Christians can discover the value of love, marriage, and family, really for the whole African-American community to discover the value of love, marriage, and family, in Jesus' name. I wrote a book over 30 years ago, and in regards to relationships, I've been writing several books on those, and I've mentioned them during this series because I have a heart for singles and the transition from singleness to marriage. And again, I wrote this book probably over 30 years ago, but I believe this book is relevant for today. It is titled, How to Choose a Worthy Mate and Find True Love. It's not just an academic look, academic study. It is sharing my failures in love. And through my pain, you can get the past to how to choose a worthy mate. And one of the things I shared in this book was a section entitled Love Potion Number 9, The Five Elements of True Love. And I used the Greek language in which the Bible was written in because it's more precise. I believe there's over 10 words for the word, the one word in English that we have, love. And I share four of them before I talk about what I'm going to talk about today, which is the divine love. I talk about the love at first sight, this epithume kind of love, this Greek language word. Romantic kind of love is eros. That's the emotional kind of love. Storge, another Greek word for social love, the family love. And also there's a love, phileo, which is that friendship kind of love. And I say that you should have all five, but we're going to talk about the most important today in this book is the divine love, which is agape, which is agape. Those of you who have been around the church for a while know about this love. But agape is defined as totally unselfish love that has the capacity to give and keep on giving without expecting anything in return. It is not dependent upon your feelings. Agape brings a person's feelings into obedience to the will. See, if you have a relationship that's only based on your feelings, I say this all the time, your feelings are not facts. You can feel wrong about something or someone that's good for you. As a matter of fact, there's a lady that's listening right now because some man saw and said she was cute. She's feeling real fancy towards him when she got a man at home that's taking care of her and all of her needs. But because she's not feeling love, she's treating her feelings like facts, and she's going to give her life away to a man that doesn't want to do anything but to use her. Your feelings are not facts, and that's the reason our relationships are not lasting these days, is because people are going off of feelings. That's why that red pill movement is saying that men should not marry today, because they're going off of their feelings, and that feelings are not facts. Marriage, love, and family is the greatest blessing that you can have on planet Earth. And men today are not even approaching women. And many of them say because of these modern women who want the 666, six packs, six figures, money, and 6 feet. And I told you on the program, I believe last Sunday, is that that's the mark of the beast. And these guys are beasting to our communities and going to our women like rock stars. These are not the kind of men that can manifest the divine love. And if you're going to have love, marriage, and family, you've got to come to terms with this divine love. And I'm going to teach you about this today as we look into a text today, which is Colossians 13 and 14. And there we see that that Greek word is agape love. And let me go ahead and read this in your hearing. And again, we should be in a protest. We should be in an uproar. We should be mad because 70% of our households don't have a man, a marriage, or a committed relationship. And we should be marching upon Washington. And we should have men who believe in Black love and Black family. Women who believe in Black love and Black families should be giving our speeches. And we should have a dream like Martin Luther King had a dream for the Black family and for Black love. Can we dream of love today? In Jesus' name, because this matters in Jesus' name. Black love must matter because of Christ. I'm going to read today Colossians chapter 14, verse 15 and 17, and it says, and over all these virtues, put on love. And in the Bible, we always tell you, in the Bible study, you always look back before this, because it's referring to something before this, and these virtues of patience, virtues of forgiveness, and of all these great virtues are mentioned earlier. It says, put on love, put on agape, which binds them all together in perfect unity. That's the power of love. It has the ability to bind together perfect unity, and it does it in marriage. Let the peace of Christ rule in your heart, since as the members of one body, you are called to peace, and relationships must have peace. Some of you are in relationships and you're warring in your relationships. You're fussing and fighting, cussing all the time, which shows that your relationship doesn't have love in it, not agape love, in Jesus' name. Verse 17, and whatever you do, this is the loyalty of love and marriage. Whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of Jesus Christ. That's why you hear me say Jesus in Jesus' name all the time, because I'm doing and fighting this battle in Jesus' name, giving thanks to God the Father through him. I read to you Colossians chapter 3, verses 14 through 15 and verse 17. May God only bless the doers of his holy and magnificent word. Black love must matter because of Christ. We have to put on love in marriage. We have to put on loyalty or peace in marriage. We have to put on loyalty in marriage. Christians must put on love, agape, in their marriage in Jesus' name. Again, we should be protesting. We should be angry. As I say in this book, in order for Black lives to matter, Black love must matter. Because of the statistics I share in this book, because of the lack of Black love, the Black family, our children are more likely to have a criminal lifestyle. Our children are more likely to go to prison. Our women are more likely to prostitute themselves over the internet through fans only or Instagram because they are showing themselves. They had a real male presence who was raised them. They would have enough self-esteem to know that they don't need those likes to feel valuable. Woo! They don't need those hearts to feel valued. They don't need all these friends. They call them friends. They're not friends. To be valuable is because they've never had a man and never been in a family where it taught them their worth. And this is why Black love must matter and Black family must matter, because we've left our street, our children out in the streets, and they're fending for themselves. And it's evident they're moving away from marriage, family, and commitment in Jesus' name. See, in marriage, you must put on love. And this is the kind of love that is void of emotions. This is the kind of love that put Christ on the cross and kept him there and enabled him to die for our sins. For John 3:16 says, "For God so loved," and that's that agape word, "the world that he gave his only, his one and only son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." And if you do not know Christ today, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and you shall be saved. And Christ is the example of love that God commands a husband to apply in marriage in Ephesians chapter 25:25. Husbands, love, agape your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. Marriage is grown folk business. If we're going to get to and move our boys to men and move them from this red pill movement, which is telling them that they should live a selfish lifestyle as opposed to giving their lives up for a marriage. And now these got to be worthy women, though. Again, I wrote the book, How to Choose a Worthy Mate and Find True Love. You just can't marry just anybody. And I want to encourage those of that movement. Don't give up on love. Don't give up on women. You've just got to find the right ones. Not allow these delusional women to make you delusional about love, marriage, and family. This is something that God has set for you, and he wants to bless you in it and through it. But you've got to be a man and not live by your emotions. It says agape, void of emotions. You've got to make the choice that you're going to commit, and that you're going to have a family, and that you're going to have children. You're going to raise these children in admonition of God in Jesus' name. Another place where it says to apply this love is in church relationships. In Corinthians, it says, love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. It does not boast. And it is not proud. And down there in 8, it says, love, agape, never fails. And we want to make these kind of relationships. We want to turn back time to where, in the 60s, it said over 80% of our households had a marriage in it, a family in it. And our community has been utterly destroyed. We got to apply this kind of love that Colossians talks about, as I shared before, that binds us all together in perfect unity. And these are four different Bible texts that should be applied in the context of Christian marriage, as well as in the context of Christian relationships. If you're married to another Christian, it's in the context of Christian relationships as well. Christian couples and sisters should apply this kind of love, because John 3:16 says it's perfect example of God's love. We need this in our churches. We need this in our community. We need real love. Many of our songs don't sing about real love anymore. Talking about using men and using women and calling people outside of their names. There's no musicology to what they do, and it's affecting the minds and poisoning the minds of people to where they feel that there is no love anymore. There is love, and you have to manifest it, men. You have to apply it, women, to your relationship with worthy men, not the 666 brothers, the mark of the beast, but worthy men. In Jesus' name, the Lord of marriage. Now, this has to do with peace. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts. One of the reasons why relationships don't last anymore is because love for you is a battle. If you're fighting in your relationship and there's no peace in your relationship, it usually generally means there's no God in one or both of you. If you're always fighting, if you're always battling, this is a dead-end relationship, but you are drawn to those kinds of people and relationships. That's why you got to pick up my book, How to Choose a Worthy Mate and Find True Love, because I take you through it. Many of you have been through counseling, but you haven't learned these principles. This is a learned thing. This is not something that you're going to feel, because this kind of relationship will not feel right to you because you've grew up like I did in dysfunction. And dysfunction feels right as opposed to peace and the relationship. That's why I say all the time, your feelings are not facts. You've got to allow your will to inform your feelings about what the true facts are. You've got to have this kind of peace in your relationship. This author there in Delhi, India, wrote about things to do to bring more peace in a relationship. And we need peace in our relationship. In a relationship, finding ways to make it peaceful is very important, she says. Sister Dahl says that everything else getting more chaotic in a relationship should be healthy in a warm place for people to come back and to be vulnerable in. In a relationship, a lot of effort and compromise and understanding is required to make things work out. Understanding the perspective of each other and embracing the differences and imperfections and changes enables us to have a healthy and peaceful relationship. It is the most important that we can learn is to prioritize ourselves. We can also seek ways to maintain peace in our relationships. And this is a great barometer. And I could tell you today, whether or not you're in a dead-end relationship, doesn't have any peace in it. It doesn't have any peace. It's dead-end. It's dead-end, especially for Christian couples, because remember I talked about that agape word and church love for the Corinthians. And you are a Christian and your wife is a Christian. Both of you got to apply this word of agape. Now, men must apply it in marriage, but in Christian relationships, both couples has to apply agape in marriage. Colossians is the same way. Because it's with this agape that we can allow to let the peace of Christ rule in our hearts. Since as members of one body, we're called to peace, and we do that through agape and thankfulness. And peace must reign in our marriages, family, and churches. And we have a whole lot of churches that lack agape love, and that's why there's so much drama going on in the churches today. That's why so many people have been turned off by many churches today, because there's not peace even in the church nowadays. Don't get turned off by all churches because you run into one church that don't have peace. You've got to find, just like I'm encouraging these young people today, to find a peaceful woman, find a peaceful man. All this stuff that you're seeing online, most of it is a lie. It is not the truth. You don't have to give yourself and your life away to a lie. All you got to do is find one good church. All you got to do is find one good woman, one good man. And your Christianity can be made, and your marriage and family can be made. This last point, as I'm running out of time, we talked about today on A Word from the Lord TV, Black love must matter because of Christ. We're following the example of Christ, the agape love that kept him on the cross to die for our sins and was buried and raised again on the third day. must put on loyalty in marriage. Somebody's listening at the sound of my voice, and you are married, and you're tempted to leave your marriage. No, that's not the way God planned it. You must be loyal to your marriage. It's a decision of the will that should last a lifetime, and your feelings are not facts. I know you just had a bad argument. I know it's tough living with her. I know it's tough living with him. But he's not being physically abusive to you, or she's not the same. Marriage is a place of loyalty. But many marriages are like some of these single brothers and sisters. You're looking at what's going on in our culture today because of what's going on social media, and people can swipe left and swipe right. My wife asked me if I had that app, and I said, no, I don't have that app. And why did she ask me? Because, you know, I try to use technology to reach people, but I would never have that app. What I need to swipe right or left? I've already swiped 18 years ago. Hello, somebody. And I made a decision. People can nowadays can swipe right and left. Over 100 people. They could DM on Instagram, and it makes it seem like these beautiful people, beautiful men and beautiful women, are accessible. They're those that don't have any loyalty there in New York. You would think in a city of 8 million people, relationships would be healthy. In a cities like Los Angeles and Chicago, Atlanta and Houston and Miami and Dallas, that relationships would be healthy. People would be getting married because so many people. The problem is they're oversaturated around every corner. Is an actor, singer, runway model, social media influencer, content creator, YouTuber, Instagram / Facebook model, a fans only person, and a porn star roaming around in the real world. And you think that they are accessible. You think that they are real, and it's a lie from the pit of hell. And some of them you really don't want to be accessible to you, because they don't have what it takes to manifest true love and family. You Christian man and Christian woman, don't believe the lie of all of this accessibility. Stay married, stay loyal. Apply agape love to your marriage all around. And your black love will matter and become an example for generations to come.
We don't need another political